So I just happened to be back on the East Coast a few years back. I was trying to make me a buck like everybody else. I'll be damned if times didn't get hard. Christ, I got down on my luck. And I got tired of just roaming and bumming around. So I started thumbing my way back to my old hometown. You know, I made quite a few miles in the first couple of days. You know, I figured I'd be home in a week if my luck held out this way. And you know, it was the third night, though, and I got stranded. And it was out of the cold, lonely crossroads. And as the rain came pouring down, man, I was hungry. Yeah, I was hungry, tired, freezing. Caught myself a chill. It was just about that time. Yeah, it was just about that time that the lights of an old semi topped the hill. Should've seen me smile and heard them air brakes come on. And I climbed up into that camp right into it before. At the wheel? Well, at the wheel said a big man, and I have to say he must have weighed 210. As he stuck out a big hand and said with a grin, Big Joe's name. And his earrings called Phantom 309. Well, I asked him why I called his rig such a name. But you know, he turned to me and said, Why, son, don't you know this here rig will be putting them all to shame? Well, there ain't a driver. No, there ain't a driver on this or any other line for that matter that seen nothing but the taillights of Big Joe and Phantom 309. So we rode and we talked a better part of the night. And I told my stories and Joe told his. And I smoked up all his viceroys as we rolled along. Pushed her ahead with 10 forward gears, man. That dashboard was lit like the old Madame LaRue pinball. Serious. Semi-truck. Till almost mysteriously, well, it was the lights of a truck stop that rolled into sight. And Joe turned to me and said, I'm sorry, son, but I'm afraid this is just as far as you go. You see, I kind of got to be making a turn just up the road a piece. I'll be damned if he didn't toss me a dime as he threw her in load. He said, go on in there, son, and get yourself a hot cup of coffee on Big Joe. Man. I mean to tell you, when Joe and his rig pulled off into the night, man, nothing flat that was clean out of sight. So I walked into the stop. Well, I ordered me up a cup of mud, saying Big Joe was setting this dude up. But it got so deathly quiet in that place. Yeah, it got so deathly quiet in that place. You could have heard a pin drop. And as the waiter's face turned kind of pale, I said, what's the matter? Did I say something wrong? I kind of said with a halfway grin. He said, no, son. You see, it'll kind of happen every now and then. Because every driver in here knows Big Joe, son. But let me tell you what happened just 10 years ago. 10 years ago out there at that cold, lonely crossroads. And there was a whole busload of kids, and man, they were just coming from school, and they were right in the middle when Joe topped the hill, and it could have been slaughtered except Joe turned his wheels and jackknifed. Yeah, it jackknifed. And it went into a skid, and you know, folks around here, well, he gave his life to save that bunch of kids. And out there at that cold, lonely crossroads, well, they're saying it was the end of the line for Big Joe and Phantom 309. 309. It's funny, you know, cause every now and then, yeah, every now and then, well, when the moon's holding water, well, they see that old Joe stop and give you a ride. It seems just like you, well, some hitchhiker be coming by. So here, son, he said to me, you get yourself another cup of coffee. It's all in the house. I kind of want you to hang on to that dime. Yeah, I kind of want you to hang on to that dime as a souvenir. Yeah. I want you to keep that dime as a souvenir of Big Joe. Of Big Joe and Phantom. Big Joe and Phantom 309.